External genitalia of male. So external genitalia of male is composed with specific structures called penis. So penis is considered as the male copulatory organ. So during the copulation process, so penis enters into the vagina, it appears like rod-like structure during the copulation and releases the sperms in the vagina. So that's why it is also known as intra-transmittent organ and appears like a rod. And here it is composed by a specific tissue bone is present. That bone is known as here erectile bone or baculum is present inside the tissues. So by that process, during the copulation process, here the penis will transform into rod-like structure. And by that process, it releases the sperms into the vagina by the vibratory movements of the penis within the vagina. So by that it can release the sperms into the vagina. So that's why it is also known as intra-transmittent organ. And external parts of penis, if you observe that, we can identify three regions. That is anterior part, middle part and the posterior part. So anterior part of penis is known as root of penis, and the middle part of penis is known as body of penis, and whereas the posterior part of penis is known as glans penis. The total penis externally covered by a specific folded membrane is present. That is loose folded membrane is present. That loose folded membrane is known as prepuce. And if you see the internal structure of penis, there we can identify some types of columns of tissues will be present. There we can identify three columns of tissues will be present, and they are located in the two different parts. So upper portion or dorsal part of the penis, we can identify two columns of tissues. That columns of tissues are known as carpus cavernosa. And here the second part, here that is carpus spongiosum. Here single column is present, that is located in the ventral side and which is highly composed with vascular structures. And middle of the carpus spongiosum, it includes an opening, that is, that opening is known as urethra. So urethra generally passes the urea as well as semen. So here both the functions regarding the urethra. And during the copulation process, the urethra passes the sperms into the vagina by the movement of penis within the vagina.